Now for ETF Extra. Oliver Porcher is president of Gary Goldberg Financial Services, and Chip Cobb is senior vice president at Bryn Mawr Trust. Let me kick off with you then, with your view, Oliver, of the ETFs. What's hot as far as you're concerned at the moment?
Sure. So we're very thematic in our ETF approach, and we like the emerging market story. But when we look at the emerging market story, Simon, we recognize that home builders and infrastructure expansion are going to be the big winners there. So we're looking for the smaller cap emerging market ETFs.
Why will they be the winners, do you think?
Because that's where the value is. The large cap companies tend to be the big Baidu's names in China, the names that you can buy individually with some security. So again, we look at ETFs at Gary Goldberg Financial Services as a way to get exposure to areas of the market that you can't easily get in other ways. So it's silver on the commodity space to hedge against inflation. It's a small cap emerging market exposure to capture on that story. It's the equal weight S&P 500 as opposed to just buying the 10 large names, which really drive the S&P in itself.
All right, what's your take on, Chip? What's your best idea right now?
Aaron, we really do like the kind of the core and the tactical approach. Core strategy would be to we look at both here domestic and international. We like DVY, which is the iShares Select Dividend Fund, as well as the International Select Dividend Fund. And that would be a core strategy because of, you know, the high quality, high dividend paying names. From a tactical approach, though, we like the materials, as Oliver was just describing. We like that space. It's got a very attractive dividend yield as well, over 3%. But we know that this global recovery is going to continue, and we feel that that's one place to be bullish about.
And you're confident, I know I've been pushing this today, but it does seem we're sort of at $108 a barrel. I mean, you're confident that global economy can continue to expand, materials will continue to rise with energy prices going up so rapidly?
I mean, we certainly recognize that there's going to be volatility. Inventory is going to be an issue. The commodity prices are going to be an issue. But we do believe that this is a, you know, this is a longer term approach, and this is a place where you can be, as I said, be tactical and add an overweight to this position. Remember, materials only represent about 3.5% of the S&P. So this is a one place where you can go ahead and take a little bit of extra approach on it.
We're out of time, Oliver, but I just want to ask you before you go. Brigny Associates put out a piece on Friday where they said, actually, stock picking is what people should be doing, not ETFs, because you have these stocks when they do well that have doubled the performance of the S&P, Priceline, Massey Energy, Anadarko, Netflix. Go with the momentum on those individual stocks.
I agree with that 100%, and so do we at Gary Goldberg Financial Services. However, if you have a smaller portfolio and you don't want to take that systemic risk of buying just an individual security, picking three or four or five stocks, and you want broader exposure, ETFs are a wonderful way to get that exposure. For example, on high-yield stocks, you can buy the new iShares HDV, which is a high-dividend-paying stock portfolio. Again, better than just being concentrated in four or five names if you have limited funds to do that with.
Okay. All right, guys, thank you very much. Thanks, Chip.
Thank you.
Thank you, Oliver.